So I saw this pop up under suggested videos on YouTube a couple days ago, and I bookmarked it because I knew I had to end up reacting to it. This is Falling in Reverse covering Gangsta's Paradise. And apparently this is off a compilation album. This came out like 10 years ago, called Punk Goes 90s, Volume 2. I've heard of that compilation album. Like, I've heard of like that general series of compilation albums. But now that I've been getting more into Falling in Reverse, and I've heard the new single, I reacted to it. Go back and watch it if you missed that reaction. Probably this one will get uploaded the day after that one. But suffice it to say, I have been becoming a mega fan of Falling in Reverse. I've loved everything I've heard so far. So before I get into it, I'm Blake X, this is Nuclear Reactions. If you're new around here, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Check out my Patreon, linked in the description down below. If you join Tier 4 on Patreon, you can make a song request and guarantee a reaction. So if that's something you're interested in, definitely check it out. Alright, Falling in Reverse, Gangster's Paradise. Now, this should go without saying, but for those who may be new to the channel, I don't know much about rap at all. I don't have a background in rap. I didn't grow up listening to it. But even I know the song Gangster's Paradise, and I believe Coolio is the one who did the song originally. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments below. So yeah, we're just going to dive into this. Apparently this includes a music video, so we'll see what happens in the video. And this is from the early days, I'm guessing, of Falling in Reverse. Once again, this came out 10 years ago. So it'll just be interesting to see how this sounds. Let's get into it. Okay, he's keeping that iconic sound. Good. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life. Oh, Coolio's in this video, huh? There's nothing left. Cause I've been laughing and blasting so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk. Yeah, you know that's unheard. You better watch how you're talking. Okay, I like that he uses his own singing voice in this. And like, why wouldn't he, right? But the thing is, he's not trying to sound like the original. He's using his regular singing voice, and it sounds good so far. It sounds good, but it's also throwing me off to hear Ronnie's singing voice paired with this iconic sound of this song. But so far, so good. And where you're walking, or you and your homies might be lying to chalk. I really hate the trip, but I gotta look. Oh shit. Didn't expect heavy guitar in this. Okay, so this is like a straight up metal cover of the song. That's awesome. Everything sounds better with heavy guitar added to it. Everything. And I've said this before on some reactions that I've done to, like, kind of rap rock songs. Like, there was one Tom McDonald song that I said this on. I think that rapping works very well with having heavy guitar in the background. Like, I just think that's a really good pairing. So, I like how he's doing it. I like how he's covering it, but he's injecting his own style into it. Very cool. Was raised by the streets, so I gotta be down with the hood team. Too many television watching got me chasing dreams. I'm an educated fool with money on my mind. I got it. Okay, so he is kind of rapping too. Gleam in my eye. I'm a loped out gangsta shit tripping banger. And my homies are down, don't arouse my anger. I like how he transitions from the rapping back into his signature singing style. And it's a very smooth transition. That's awesome. Also, I'm seeing Coolio in this video. Is he going to have a rapping part in this? Like, is he going to do a guest part in this? Or is he solely in the video itself? I don't know. That remains to be seen. But it does say something when the original artist is willing to be in and support your music video. That says something about how much they respect your version of it. Ain't nothing but a heartbeat away. I'm living life do or die. What can I say? I'm 23 now, but will I live to see 24 the way things are going? Now, if we could just get first vocals to this, it'll be perfect. Ask and you shall receive, apparently. Let's spend it, most of our lives, living in the gangsta's paradise. Okay, we're going to wind that back again because I want to hear that screaming part again. We'll take it back to the 130 mark. But yeah, I like this. I like the style and the vibe of this video. Roddy's kind of got a gangster look going, but it kind of suits him too. Like, if you know his personality and you know his energy, it just fits. I like that he did a little bit of his own rapping, not just the singing. And then, of course, like, as soon as I said it, the screaming kicks in. I love it, man. I love it. Let's continue. Jet tripping banger. And my homies are down. Don't arouse my anger. Death ain't nothing but a heartbeat away. I'm living life, do or die. What can I say? I'm 23 now, but will I live to see 24 the way things are going? I don't know. So tell me why I'm being so fucking blind to say. Why is this cover so good? Okay, I noticed in the background when he was doing the screaming parts, Coolio was just like covering his face. Was that just kind of like Coolio being like, I don't like the screaming part? Or am I just overthinking it? Like, I wonder how, like, a lot of rappers feel about, like, harsh vocals in metal. And I wonder how they feel about metal in general. Like, if there's any, like, behind-the-scenes videos or, like, info about this, let me know in the comments. Because I'd like to check that out on my own time. But this cover is, like, better than it has any right to be. And I think only a band like Falling in Reverse could do a cover like this and make it good. And apparently earn the support of the original artist who did it. Love to see it. Money and the power, minute after minute, hour after hour, everybody's running, but half of them ain't looking. What's going on in the kitchen? But I don't know what's cooking. But I gotta learn, like nobody's here to teach me. I can understand how can they reach me. Those are deep growls, too. I guess they laugh. What's there's in front? That's more than life is out of luck. Okay, so both my girlfriend Rachel and people in comments on previous reactions have told me that Ronnie is capable of doing deep growls and roars, you know, and just deeper harshes in general. It's not that I didn't believe it, but to actually hear it in a song like this, that's fantastic. I mean, he's just such a well-rounded vocalist. Just had to say that. See what I mean?
Fuck everyone! Records, Punko's 90s. Shout out to all the bands on the record. Falling in Reverse, 2014 and beyond. Gangster's Paradise, baby. Let's spend the most of our lives living in a gangster's paradise. Let's spend the most of our lives living in a gangster's paradise. Can't spend the most of our lives living in a gangster's paradise.
You know, every time I hear a new Falling in Reverse song, I know this isn't new, but you know what I mean. Every time I hear a song by these guys, I come away thinking one of two things, sometimes both things. I either think this is fucking crazy, or I didn't know that I needed this in my life. And it's usually both of those things simultaneously. And that's the case for this song. I did not know that I needed a cover of Gangster's Paradise by Falling in Reverse in my life. But I'm so glad that it's a thing. Like, I don't know. There's some unique energy or spark about Falling in Reverse, I'm finding, that I really vibe with. Because, like, the style Ronnie sings in, even though I love it, when it comes to other singers who sing in that style, I'm not as much of a fan of those types of bands. So I don't know why I gravitate so strongly to Falling in Reverse, but the more I've heard by them, like, the more I'm just loving everything. Like, I'm always coming away really impressed. I just like the vibes. I like the energy. I like the style. There's also a certain bluntness and attitude that comes through in every single song by this band. And that is something that I'm really drawn to. So it's just, and they're also so adventurous, you know? They're willing to do covers like this. They're willing to experiment with country music. They're willing to ask Tech N9ne to do guest vocals on a song. They're willing to have Alex Terrible on the same song. They're not afraid to push the envelope. They're not afraid to take risks. And risk-taking is something that hardly anyone does anymore, especially artists. I don't know why. Maybe it's just because everything is algorithm-driven these days on social media and YouTube, and so people just kind of follow that, and they look at what's trending, and they just try and replicate it. I feel like Ronnie and Falling in Reverse in general just say, fuck it, we're going to do what we want to do. We're going to do our own thing. If we want to make a country song, we're going to make a country song. If we want to make a metal song, so on and so forth. And so I guess at some point, maybe the guys behind Punk Goes 90s approached Ronnie about this, or maybe it was his own idea, but at some point he decided, all right, I'm going to cover Gangster's Paradise. And on top of that, I'm going to get Coolio to be in the video with me. Oh, man. This is like, and I can't believe this is 10 years old, by the way, because this feels new to me. I don't know why. Like, the video doesn't feel like it was filmed 10 years ago. And I, of course, maybe that's just because I just discovered this. Like, I didn't even know this existed, this cover, up until a couple days ago. But I don't know, this, it feels like this falls right in line with a lot of the newer material from Falling in Reverse. Like, I would not be surprised if I heard this cover on the new record, you know? So that's just really cool, and I think that it speaks to how timeless this band's music is. It just ages like wine. So I like that there were harshes on this, I like that Ronnie has multiple styles that he uses on this, singing, rapping parts, and again, he transitions from one to the other very fluidly, seemingly effortlessly, and that's the mark of a talented person. I just like the overall energy to this, and it just, it's a song that just goes for it. It's a metal cover of Gangster's Paradise, and it just goes for it in a very honest way, and a very direct way. And it just works. Somehow it just works. And I don't think that a cover of the song would work for virtually any other metal band out there. There's just some kind of magic that Falling in Reverse has, where they can capture a song like this in a respectful way, in a way that doesn't feel forced, and in a way that just feels fun and rewarding when you listen to it. That's my initial impression. So, I'm so glad that I discovered this. Like, this wasn't even a request. This just ended up on my radar. You know, I went down the rabbit hole one night on YouTube, and this popped up. I was like, I definitely have to react to this shit. So, I feel like I say this all the time when I react to Falling in Reverse, but I'm thoroughly impressed. I really, really like this one. It's just fun. It just is. So, I might even add this to a playlist, you know? I'm going to be traveling later tonight, and I'll probably add this to my playlist while I'm sitting on the train for 8 hours. So, I'm going to wrap it up here on this one, guys. But let me know if you like this song, and let me know if there are any other covers out there that Falling in Reverse has done that I may not know about. Because, for all I know, there could be another Punk Goes 90s album where they contributed a song. I don't know. But I do know I enjoyed this. So there's more content on the way. If you're new here, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on your way out the door. Check out Patreon, link down below in the description. Much love to the Nuclear family, and I will catch you all on the next one.